There's nothing that the president takes more seriously than the security of the American people. The story that came out tonight, as reported, is false. The president and the foreign minister reviewed a range of common threats to our two countries, including threats to civil aviation. At no time, were intelligence sources or methods discussed. And the president did not disclose any military operations that were not already publicly known. Two other senior officials who were present, including the Secretary of State, remember the meeting the same way and have said so. Their on-the-record accounts should outweigh those of anonymous sources. And I was in the room. It didn't happen. Thanks, everybody. Thank you.
Let's go to Kristen Welker on that. Kristen, I think what we're seeing there is someone denying something that wasn't asserted in the news articles, the Times and the Post, starting with the Post. The Washington Post asserted that basically they discussed, he discussed, gave away operational information about a coming a terrorist plot. And it's actually the identity of the spot where it's going to occur. So there was that kind of information. Nobody ever said that the president gave away the tip where we got it from, simply what the tip was. I thought that denial was a non-denial denial. Anyway, your thoughts. Your reporting.
I think you're absolutely right. They continue to go back to this wording, sources and methods. That is not what was in the Washington Post report. The Washington Post report states that President Trump relayed classified information that he obtained from one of the United States allies. And you didn't hear McMaster address that very specific issue. He also talked about military operations that were widely known and widely reported. Again, that doesn't deal with what the Washington Post reported, which is that there was information that the president conveyed. I also thought it was significant. You heard H.R. McMaster say, I was there. It didn't happen. So expect him to get a lot of heat, a lot of pressure in the coming hours and the coming days, Chris, to clarify specifically what went down in that meeting. I can't underscore this point enough. This was a meeting that President Trump had with Sergey Lavrov and Kislyak. The Russian media was there. The American media wasn't there. And that is one of the reasons why that becomes a problem. Again, this is yet another explosive headline, frankly, for this administration related to Russia at a moment when they, frankly, can't afford it. The president wanted to be focused on his big foreign trip at the end of the week to be picking a new FBI director. Instead, the focus now on this latest controversy, Chris.
White House officials are very tight-lipped about this story in the Washington Post that President Trump, during that meeting with the Russian Foreign Minister Sergey Lavrov and the Russian Ambassador Sergey Kislyak, that he revealed classified, highly classified information to those Russians during that Oval Office meeting. It apparently had something to do with code word information that came through a U.S. ally about intelligence regarding the Islamic State. That is all we know at this point in terms of what the Washington Post is reporting. Now, we can tell you, Wolf, that within the last hour, the National Security Advisor, H.R. McMaster, walked by reporters in the press area of the West Wing. He was peppered with questions about all of this, and he essentially told those reporters to the effect of, this is the last place I want to be right now, and then he walked away from those reporters. But, Wolf, we have repeatedly asked White House officials, national security officials over here at the White House for some kind of comment or confirmation of this story. We should point out at this point, we have not received any kind of comment or confirmation on this Washington Post reporting. But Wolf, if it's true, if the president did reveal highly classified information to the Russians during that meeting, which, by the way, came under a lot of scrutiny because, remember, this meeting happened one day after he fired the FBI director, James Comey, potentially and apparently about, or at least it's some part about, his concerns about the Russian investigation. The optics of that meeting obviously were under heavy criticism at the time. But if the president also revealed classified information to the Russians during that Oval Office meeting, it is going to recall all sorts of questions and flashbacks to the campaign of last year when the president time and again hammered Hillary Clinton, accusing her of revealing classified information through her private email practices and that use of her server. And so, Wolf, if this turns out to be true, and you heard John McCain there caution to Manu Raju that they don't have confirmation of that yet, this is going to create just a whole slew of nasty questions for this White House, Wolf.
Breaking new details about that North Korean missile launch. New photos this morning show Kim Jong-un celebrating the test as North Korea claims their rocket could carry a nuclear warhead. Our chief global affairs anchor, Martha Raddatz, starts us off. Good morning, Martha.
Good morning, George. U.S. officials say they have no information right now to verify the claim the missile could carry a nuclear weapon. But make no mistake, this missile launch was significant and showed real progress. This is the first successful test of this type of missile. Experts believe this was a medium-range ballistic missile, which means U.S. bases in the Pacific could potentially be targeted. The missile was launched from the western part of North Korea and traveled more than 400 miles at an altitude of more than 1,200 miles, landing in the Sea of Japan about 60 miles from Russia. The launch has been widely criticized, the White House saying North Korea has been a flagrant menace for far too long and calling on other nations to implement far stronger sanctions against North Korea. There have been 7 missiles tested since Donald Trump took office, and Kim shows no sign of stopping. This is also the first test since South Korea elected a president who favors dialogue with the North. George?
Continuing to pressure. Okay, Martha Raddatz, thanks very much.